big political story we're tracking this Saturday. There was high drama at the Aam Aadmi Party's National Council meeting this morning. Founding members Prashant Bhushan and Yugendra Yadav were sacked, ending the month-long drama. A resolution for the ouster of Yugendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan was moved by Manish Sisodia, the Deputy Chief Minister of Delhi and a close confidant of Party Chief Arvind Kejriwal. The resolution was backed by a majority of AAP members, leading to the ouster of the two senior leaders from the party's national executive. After the meeting, the duo held a press conference alleging the meeting was fixed. They also accused the Kejriwal camp of heckling and abusing them and their supporters inside the meeting. Lashing out at Kejriwal, Yugendra Yadav said that democracy was murdered at the AAP meet. Hitting back at the duo, the AAP claimed these allegations were untrue. Earlier this morning, before the meeting had started, Yugendra Yadav was heckled by Kejriwal supporters. Yugendra Yadav, in fact, even sat in a dharna after several National Council members were reportedly denied entry into the meeting by the Kejriwal camp. Camp at this stage. Here's a look at the three options that Bhushan and Yadav and their supporters are likely to explore. Number one, the election, which is to approach the Election Commission. Number two, challenging the decision taken by the party's national executive in court. And number three, calling a national executive meeting.
What was happening here? The movement, the entire thing was pre-scripted. Ramzan Chaudhary is here. He is a member of the National Council. He was dragged out of the room by bouncers who had actually kicked him. ये जो कल कह रहे थे ना कि इन्हें लातों से मार के बाहर करना चाहिए, that was physically enacted.
जो मारपीट की बात कही जा रही है, एकदम गलत बात है, एकदम झूठी बात है. कोई मारपीट नहीं हुई है. रमजान चौधरी जी खुद उठ खड़े होकर जोर जोर से चिल्लाने लगे. हमारे कुछ साथी उनको समझाने गए, उनको कहा कि आप बैठ जाइए.
जो लोग ने भी ये हुड़दंग जो वहाँ हुलिगनिज्म जो चल रहा था जिसमें एमएलए शामिल थे, उस हुलिगनिज्म को रोकने की कोशिश करी, उनको जरूर लात मार के.
Let's get a word from Jugal Purohit, who's with us live this afternoon. Jugal, allegations of heckling and manhandling coming out from Prashant Bhushan, Yugendra Yadav camp. They claim that their supporters weren't even allowed entry inside the National Council meeting. There are a couple options that they are likely to explore. What seem to be the most likely ones?
There is no doubt that Prashant Bhushan, Yugendra Yadav and all those people who come out of the Aam Aadmi Party National Council meet, along with them, are not going to take it all lying down. According to what we understand and what we got to learn from Prashant Bhushan and Yadav during the press conference today at 6 p.m. in the Nizamuddin area is where they've called a meeting whereby they want to discuss the future course of action, because as I said, they will be giving Arvind Kejriwal and the other side of the Aam Aadmi Party a tough fight, a run for their money. In all likelihood, they may approach the court. They also have the option of approaching the Election Commission of India, since the Aam Aadmi Party is a registered party, has to perform as per the norms of the Election Commission of India. So there are several options that they have right now. They also want to see just what is the final outcome of the National Council itself, because that's a meeting from which they came out midway. They did not see it through. So what has been decided and what not is something that we are all awaiting. We were given to understand that at 4 p.m. Manish Sisodia was to address a press conference and talk about everything and give an update about everything that the National Council had decided. That is something that we are waiting for. And of course, the 6 p.m. meeting that Prashant Bhushan has called in Nizamuddin, the Jangpura area where his office is, will be extremely crucial in understanding just what is the next step ahead for these leaders.
All right, so the two sides expected to hold two more press conferences to present their side of the story. Meanwhile, earlier in the morning, there were some angry reactions that came in from both factions. Jugal, stay on with us. We're going to come back to you in just a bit. Let's once again listen into some of those reactions we managed to get from outside the National Council meeting.
मैंने सिर्फ इतना भर दोनों पक्षों की सुनने के बाद वोटिंग कराई. आप सिर्फ इतना, दो आदमी उन्हें पकड़ा, बाहर ले आए, बाहर दो तीन थे, उन्होंने लातों से और मुक्कों से, फिर मेरे पैन वगैरह सारे टूट गए और बाहर लाकर एक कोने में बिठा दिया. जब तक ये मीटिंग खत्म नहीं हो जाती तब तक यहीं बैठे रहेंगे जेल. आज मेरे साथ ये क्या, पकड़ कर बाहर लाकर मेरा पैर टूट गया, शायद मेरे पर खड़ा नहीं हुआ जा रहा, लेकिन मुझे बाहर बिठा दिया कोने में, जैसे जेलियों को बिठा दिया।
केजरीवाल वॉज द ओनली वन हु स्पोक एंड देन ही सेड दैट नाउ आई हैव टू लीव फॉर सम अर्जेंट वर्क। देन श्री मनीष सिसोदिया टुक ओवर एंड ही सेड दैट यू हैव हर्ड अरविंद जी एंड हिज ऑफर।
Here what was the operation?
Here is the resolution.
Who tabled the resolution?
Manish ji moved the resolution saying that 167 people of the National Council have proposed that Professor Yogendra Yadav, Prashant Bhushan, Anand Kumar and Ajit Jha should be removed from the National Executive. How many for it? How many against it? In between, Gopal Rai, who was chairing, asked for names. Who will like to speak?
But before,
Gopal Raji was chair. While they invited names, there was a call that let there be show of hands. And we said, how can you do this without any discussion, without other side taking floor? Unfortunately, it was quite noisy, scuffling. We preferred to come out of that very ugly situation. I have been in politics for 50 years. I have gone through many other experiences of political debates, but never like this, never like this. It's very dangerous beginning, but we stay in the party, na chodenge, na todenge, sudharenge, sudharenge.
एक उम्मीद और अपेक्षा के साथ दिल्ली की जनता ने एक सरकार बनाई है और जनता की अपेक्षा है कि उस सरकार के लोग, उस दल के लोग जो वायदे किए हैं उनको निभाएं। केवल राजनीतिक अनुभवहीनता उसके आधार पर इस ऐतिहासिक अवसर को ना खोएं। और ये जो नई राजनीति आई है कि राजनीतिक नेता एक दूसरे से बात करें तो उसको टेप कर ले, खैर इस नई राजनीति की मुझे उम्मीद नहीं थी।
Criticism coming in from the opposition for the Aam Aadmi Party. Jugal Purohit is with us live from the national capital. Jugal, even as the Kejriwal camp manages to throw out Yogendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan from the party's national executive, this camp and the party has now opened itself to severe criticism. Kejriwal especially now under scanner for running the party as an autocrat.
That's right, Simi, but this allegation was never too far away insofar as Arvind Kejriwal's style of operation is concerned. Be it the case of Vinod Binny or several others who had left the Aam Aadmi Party much before what the scenes that we're seeing today, the allegation has always been that Kejriwal is a dictator of sorts. He imposes his views and does not function in a democratic format. Today is what we saw. A lot of important people who till about a couple of months ago were a part of his core team coming out and saying the exact same words. But the bigger damage, Simi, is not about the opposition. In Delhi, opposition is practically non-existent. The real problem, as I see it today and as we saw outside the National Council meeting venue, is the strength of the Aam Aadmi Party, the volunteers on the street. Those volunteers we've seen today, the scenes that perhaps would be unimaginable if one is to go back just a couple of months. Volunteers fighting among each other, volunteers holding banners of different camps, so to say, volunteers having making snide remarks at Arvind Kejriwal's leadership. The entire strength of the Aam Aadmi Party today seem to be fighting each other rather than fighting together. And this is perhaps in the opinion of a lot of people, because Aam Aadmi Party has always claimed itself to be a party of street fighters, a party of street fighters in the sense that, you know, people from the street have picked up issues and fought for them. It's that very core constituency of the Aam Aadmi Party which today stands divided, stands disgusted and stands in shock and is leaderless in many cases. So that's where the Aam Aadmi Party's biggest challenge will lie. The fact that its core constituency support base has been diluted, and things will never be the same again, perhaps.
Absolutely. Lots of people in Delhi who in fact had come out and voted for the Aam Aadmi Party would be disappointed by the behavior of leaders that they put out this morning. Jugal, stay on with us. The Kejriwal camp hit back at Yugendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan and claimed that their charges were in fact baseless. In a series of tweets, AAP leader Ashutosh said, and I quote, "Yugendra Yadav is spreading lies that NC members were beaten up inside the meeting. There was no scuffle or manhandling. It's a cooked up story to gain sympathy. Only a dozen members opposed the proposal to expel them from the NE and a few walked out of Yugendra Yadav and Prashant Bhushan. Overwhelming support to expel them from the NE. Yugendra Yadav, Prashant Bhushan should respect the verdict of the highest decision-making body of the party if they believe in internal democracy."